What did it take to Bob Arum? Recently, he stated that he's been in talks with Heyman, that they could possibly work together. What do you think about those possible matchups there, man, between top-ranking
listen,
PBC?
Man, you know, for the benefit of the fans, and you know what? Man, listen, for the benefit of the fighters, because it's at the end of the day, right, you taking food off the table off of fighters who this is a short career. I'm saying this is not a long career. You can't do this till you're 40.
Yeah.
And it's like all the potential fights and the big paydays that could be made, but they're not happening because of beef.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Listen, I'm pretty sure I could have been fought Peter Quillen in a rematch.
Yeah.
If this beef wasn't going down. You know what I'm saying? Because the fight between me and Peter Quillen was so controversial that it's one of those fights that it has to be a rematch. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But why doesn't that fight happen? It doesn't happen because of the beefs.
Yeah.
You know, so I think for the benefit of the fighters and fans, you know, you got to squash that beef. And promoters got to put their egos to the side and stop thinking about themselves because, you know, they made their money. Fighters try to eat too. We got families. You know, we got to put food on the table too.
Yeah.
So it's like, and the fans want to see the good fights. Sometimes fights are being made because the fights that really should be happening can't happen because of the powers that be, you know?
Yeah. What do you take to that Vargas top-ranking PBC potentially working together? Bob Arum stated that, you know, all that the BS is being put aside. What do you think about those matchups there? You think that's good for boxing now?
Absolutely.
Listen, at the end of the day, they have no choice but to do that.
We need
to. It's like, they have no choice but to do that because it's like, you know, you can't keep putting big name fighters against fighters that are like not in the elite level or world class level. You know what I'm saying? You can't be doing those matchups. It's so you know.
So a lot like when Pacquiao and Mayweather fight each other, they will fight guys within their promotion most of the time. And
you know what's gonna happen, man. This is, you know, it's just a problem with egos and shit. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? It's a business of egos, pride. But they fucking it up for the fighters, though. And for the fans.
Yeah.
But I think eventually it'll stop.
What do you take to that, Vargas? Great for boxing?
Absolutely. You know what I mean?
Yo, his banana's coming right now.
When you make these...
yeah, it's the best banana in the world.
That's what I'm saying. And as a fighter, as a, you know, ex-world champion, you and been in the top game, you know... You don't even have to be in the top game. As a fighter, you know what it is to be at this point. You know, the week of the fight, a few days before the weigh-in, you're like, any little food you can have is like the best.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So,
yeah.
You know.